Hi, I'm Randy Vance. I'm on the Tampa Bay in St. Petersburg, Florida on Blackfin's new 242 dual console. This is their second dual console and one of my favorites. It's powered with dual 200 horsepower Mercury engines. Those are the new V6 motors that Mercury just came out with last year that have a lot of conveniences. The thing I like best about them is the hatch on the top that allows you easy access to change your oil without wrestling with the motor cowling. Now that's not all. You've got power steering and electronic throttle and shift. Now the helm station is equipped with a vessel view gauge and a Garmin GPS map display. In our test with a crew of four and a full tank of gas and gear, we got a top speed of 49 miles per hour, and in the chop that we were in had a nice smooth ride. Now one of the things that makes the dual console so popular is this forward seating area. Underneath the seats are insulated compartments that can be used for dry storage, fish boxes, or coolers. When you're fishing, you can stow the cushions away, and you've got easy access to the windlass compartment at the bow. Now the dual console brings some other advantages besides the forward seating. You can close this area off in inclement weather, and then you have a very dry cockpit. There's still more that comes from a dual console. The port side console houses a large head compartment. This one has an electric flushing head, but it comes standard with a porta potty. Then on the starboard side, you've got an enormous storage compartment that's great for holding big gear, and in this case, the cocktail table for the cockpit. Now Blackfin has built a very nice back-to-back seat here. What I like about it is that you've got nice high seat backs on it, comfortable cushions, but you flip the seat backs fore and aft and you've got a full-length sun lounge. Or you can flip them just partially and have an aft-facing or a forward-facing lounge. Behind the starboard captain's chair, you've got a galley area, which is also great for bait preparation. Underneath is a slide-out Yeti cooler, that's standard, and on top is a freshwater sink with a removable shower faucet. Now right now the Blackfin's cockpit is set up for relaxing and cruising, but this transom seat snaps away in a heartbeat. Now you're ready for hardcore fishing action, and there's plenty of equipment on board for that, like this live well. You've got macerated fish boxes that pump overboard. There's plenty of rod storage on board too. Underneath the gunnels, you can stow light spinning tackle, but you've got rod holders in both gunnels and on the hardtop structure as well. There's a walkthrough to the transom. If you're into water sports, there's a large swim platform in the back, which is also handy for diving, and this boat is equipped with the optional tow pylon. Now I've always been a center console fan for saltwater fishing, but the more time I spend on dual consoles, the more I see their benefits. I like the fact that you've got so much shade from this beam-to-beam hardtop. It integrates into the windshield, it makes it extra sturdy. You can also completely enclose the area with curtains. Blackfin has done a great job of capitalizing on all the advantages of dual consoles. I'm Randy Vance on the Tampa Bay, and this is the Blackfin 242 DC.